Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. Just to shake it up a little bit, I wanted to share a few true paranormal stories that I found that I thought you guys might find interesting, and they're quite good topics for discussion, I think. So let me know what you think of that. Let me know what you think about them. So here we go. Title states, I personally know two people who truly believe they've seen leprechauns. These two stories are unfortunately going to be rather long, but I want you all to get the full details. Both of these stories take place in western Pennsylvania. The first story takes place in 1991. My ex-boyfriend's dad was the chief of police of a small town located directly outside of a city. He had several police officers who worked for him, and one was a young rookie cop whom I'll call Mike. The police officers in that jurisdiction often assisted the city police with calls. Mike was going to such a call one day in the beginning of March. He was driving down a road that on either side was a field of tall, dead brown grass. All of a sudden, Mike saw what he thought was an animal coming out of the grass on the left side. He said he saw the next sequence of events in slow motion. He tried to slow his cruiser down. He saw that it was not an animal, but indeed a small, bald, dirty man dressed in ragged clothes, approximately 2 feet tall, running out from the grass. He slammed on the brakes. The cruiser did not stop fast enough and he hit the small man with the front of the car. The man flew up into the air. Mike jumped out and ran to the front. He said he looked right down at the small man, who he then noticed had reddish brown hair. The little man began a screaming, evil laugh and hopped up, running into the grass on the right side of the road. Mike ran after him, but all he heard was the sound of his evil, mocking laugh. When Mike got back to the station, he was visibly shaken. My ex's father said he was pale white and could barely choke out the story. When he finished telling them what happened, everyone except my ex's dad began howling with laughter. The other cops teased him relentlessly about the leprechaun story. Since it was about 3 weeks before St. Patrick's Day, one of the cops went to the dollar store and bought a leprechaun hat. He left it on Mike's doorstep with a note stuck in the brim saying, "I'm coming for you, Mikey." The next morning, Mike came in crying and told my ex's father he was quitting the police. My ex's father believed Mike and said he could tell he was extremely sincere in his belief that he'd hit a leprechaun. He told the other cops to leave him alone about it, and Mike worked with him for years to come. I first heard the story from my ex's father. I could tell he really believed Mike had seen what he'd seen. Later that year, Mike was over at my ex's house. I asked Mike about the story. He grew pale and quiet, and he told me exactly the same story my ex's father had told me earlier. He insisted, and has always insisted, that he hit a leprechaun with his car that day. The second story takes place in 1998. My childhood best friend Susan grew up on one of the most haunted houses I've ever been in my life, which is a story for another day. She lived in an old farmhouse way out in the country that had been in her family for generations. It's important to understand how her upstairs was set up. You'd go up the staircase to essentially a dead end, with hallways on either side of the staircase. To the right was a very large bedroom, which was her parents' room. To the immediate left was her sister's room, then Susan's room, then an open hallway which led to the bathroom and a smaller back bedroom. Susan's bedroom had an open doorway into the hallway that faced the bathroom and small bedroom. I've always had my abilities. Susan would often tell me of odd things that happened in her house. Also, she and I would often discuss odd things that happened to both of us when I would go over there. One morning, she came into school and told me in a whisper that she had seen a leprechaun in the hallway of her room the night before. I could tell it scared her. I asked her if she'd seen it before, and she said she had. She said she'd heard rustling noises out in the hallway and gotten out of her bed to peek around the corner. In the corner of the hall, she saw a small man, approximately 2 feet tall, in dirty clothes with red hair. She froze with fear, then she said the man disappeared. She said she'd seen him before out of the corner of her eye moving in the hallway at all hours of the day. I remember her, as clear as day, saying to me that it did not look like the leprechaun in the Lucky Charms box. Being an amateur paranormal investigator, even at 9, I asked her to draw me a picture. I still have the picture somewhere at my parents'. She drew a small man with red hair standing in her hallway. She believed she saw the leprechaun one more time, but then she told me she never saw it again. It should be noted too that Susan was not asleep or in her bed the times that she thought she saw the leprechaun. She would see it out in the hallway or out of the corner of her eye while she was upstairs. I believe, too, she only saw it over a 6-month period. A lot of strange things happened at her house, and I know she believed what she saw and wasn't just making up stories. This story was from a user called ExistentialDread14. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you next time.